morning. Thank you very much for joining us here on Times Now. This is the newspaper show and I'm Hina Gambhir. So let's get started and tell you what's making headlines as far as the Times of India this morning is concerned. The biggest story that the Times of India today is leading with on the front page is odd even goes as Kejriwal unlocks Delhi but orders sealing of borders. That's the big news. Barbers and salons can open, malls to stay closed. Another update and it says Delhi is back in business. And at the same time, traffic chaos on Monday morning was witnessed at a border between Delhi and Gurugram. Now, there are new relaxations that have come from Delhiites. That's the big story. All shops and markets and complexes to open. There is not going to be any kind of an odd even for the opening of shops. Pillion riders on two-wheelers allowed. More than two passengers, excluding drivers in cars, allowed. More than one passenger in autos and e-rickshaws. And night curfew between 9 p.m. to 5 a.m. That has been changed as well. Industrial establishments can open like before. Staggered working hours not needed. So these are the big decisions that have been taken by Delhi government. And key decisions expected next week, two of them. One, whether opening of malls and religious places can happen, and permitting restaurants, hotels and hospitality services. So on these issues, next week key decision will be taken. So that's the big story that the Times of India this morning is leading with. 3 kilometer tailbacks, long wait at Gurugram border. That's another story here. Haryana's decision on Sunday to reopen its sealed borders with Delhi failed to translate into any kind of a relief for the commuters. On Monday, both police and RAF personnel carried out stringent checks at Gurugram borders, leading to tailbacks of up to 3 kilometer as thousands had to wait for an hour or more. So that's another story. Now, this is another story that Times of India this morning is leading with. Moody's downgrades India rating for first time in 22 years. As of now, no reaction has come from the government side. Moody's cites low growth, slow reforms among the key reasons for this downgrade. And global rating agency Moody's Investor Service on Monday downgraded India's sovereign rating to the lowest investment grade, saying that the country's policy-making institutions would be challenged in enacting and implementing policies which mitigate the risk of a sustained period of low growth, significant further deterioration in government's fiscal position, and stress in the financial sector. The downgrade by Moody's comes 22 years after it lowered India's rating on 19th of June back in 1998, and that happened after the nuclear tests were carried out. The lowering of the rating from Baa2 to Baa3 brings it on a par with S&P and Fitch, which rate India BBB-, that is the lowest investment grade rating for India. We'll see what the government will have to say. At the same time, there was a cabinet meeting yesterday and big decisions were taken by the government. Government has decided to keep exports out of turnover calculation for MSMEs. MSP has been hiked for 14 crops, a boost for farmers. Focus on boosting cultivation of nutria cereals such as bajra, urad and tur dal. MSP for paddy has been raised by 3%. Two funds to support ailing small businesses and capacity augmentation has been cleared by the cabinet as well. Then scheme to help street vendors to get 10,000 rupee loan has also been given a go-ahead by the cabinet yesterday. Now, monsoon has hit Kerala and IMD in its forecast has said that north is expected to get good rain. This is what Vishwa Mohan has reported on the front page. As far as India's corona count is concerned, it is now at number 7. Among the top 10 worst hit countries across the world because of coronavirus, India is at number 7 because our cases are rising sharply. Fatality rate, however, dips amid rising cases and deaths. That's another story. Then DGCA has told the airlines to keep middle seats empty, and if it is not possible, then they should give a wraparound gown to the passengers. That's another big story here. 1,000 items dropped from police canteens, then order withdrawn. A flip-flop over this issue by the centre. Now, the government has said that no fresh Chinese build-up. There has been no fresh military build-up by China along the line of actual control in eastern Ladakh. This is what official sources said on Monday. Even as Indian Army and PLA held another round of talks, in a bid to defuse the standoff. Then Jharkhand has cancelled BRO hiring drive. Jharkhand has cited the rapid spread of COVID-19 infection to cancel the permission it had given to the BRO to hold a recruitment drive in Dumka for hiring labourers for road construction work in Ladakh. So that has now been cancelled. India says Pak wants tit-for-tat action after Pakistan condemned India's move to declare its two mission officials persona non grata for spying in Delhi on Monday, accused Islamabad of making false allegations to prepare the ground for tit-for-tat action. Then ATF prices were hiked by 56% in 1 month. LPG prices went up by 11 rupees for the non-subsidized cylinders. And then man walks 2 kilometer, dies of snake bite. This has happened in UP. This man walked 2,000 kilometer for 12 days from Bengaluru to reach his place in UP. Bareilly, an hour later, 23-year-old died from a snake bite. Then Gates Foundation is now WHO's biggest funder, with the U.S. President Donald Trump announcing that the U.S. will be terminating its relationship with the World Health Organization. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation is set to become the biggest funder for the organization. Then another update about the Parliament session. Lok Sabha may convene in Central Hall for July session with social distancing norms in mind. The next session of Parliament is expected to be convened in July. That may see Lok Sabha actually vacating its chamber for Rajya Sabha and moving its proceedings to the Central Hall. That's another interesting update. Lockdown hits 20,000 crore legal practice industry. Most lawyers have no earning. This is what has been said by the Bar Council of India. And lastly, before we move on to the Navbharat Times, it's a very interesting picture that's there on the front page. Healing touch. As protests rage in US, cops take a knee. So this is how some police officers in various cities of the United States of America showed solidarity with the protesters. Police officers knelt in Coral Gables, Florida, and several other U.S. cities in a gesture of solidarity. Some even marched with demonstrators protesting the recent death of George Floyd. However, violence continued in many parts of the country. That's an interesting story on the front page, a healing touch by some cops in the United States of America. Moving on now, and let's get you the latest as far as the Navbharat Times is concerned. Aur sabse ahem aaj ki jo khabar hai, jo front page pe hai, wo hai, roz khulengi sabhi dukane, salon bhi, sawariyan bithane ki bandish jo hai, wo khatm ho gayi hai. Ye Delhi ke bare mein update diya hai, jo naye changes aaye hain abhi is phase ke lockdown mein. Delhi khuli, सीमा लॉक. बॉर्डर को सील करने की जो बात की है चीफ मिनिस्टर ने, वो भी आज फ्रंट पेज पे है. राजधानी के बॉर्डर एक हफ्ते सील, यूपी हरियाणा के भी बंद. गुड़गांव और नोएडा बॉर्डरों पर मैसिव जैम जो है देखने को मिले. आप तस्वीर भी आप देख सकते हैं, ये हरियाणा बॉर्डर की तस्वीर है जहां पर बहुत ही ज्यादा जैम कल देखने को मिला था. और उसके अलावा विमान में बीच वाली सीट खाली रखने को कहा गया है. डीजीसीए ने सभी एयरलाइंस को कहा है. दिल्ली में कोरोना मरीज 20,000 के ऊपर पहुंच गए हैं. 4 दिन बाद 1,000 से कम मामले. कम से कम पिछले 24 घंटों में 990 मामले आए, जो कुछ दिनों के मुकाबले थोड़े से कम है, क्योंकि 1,000 से ऊपर का आंकड़ा जा रहा था हर रोज. मानसून आया, रास्ते में निसर्ग. एक तरफ मानसून ने दस्तक दे दी है केरला पर, वहीं दूसरी तरफ एक अरेबियन सी में डिप्रेशन बना हुआ है जो इंटेंसिफाई हो सकता है एक साइक्लोनिक स्टॉर्म में, जिसका नाम होगा निसर्ग. तो यह भी एक खबर है. मौसम विभाग ने सोमवार को कहा कि केरल में मॉनसून पहुंच चुका है, इस बार जून से सितंबर तक सामान्य बारिश होगी. इसी बीच अरब सागर में उठा निसर्ग तूफान महाराष्ट्र और गुजरात के लिए एक नए संकट के रूप में अब उभर रहा है. यह बुधवार को दोनों राज्य के तटीय इलाकों में तबाही मचा सकता है. तो यह भी एक इंपॉर्टेंट खबर है. रेहड़ी पटरी वाले ले सकेंगे लोन. 14 फसलों के अब ज्यादा मिलेंगे दाम. एमएसपी को बढ़ा दिया गया है. और आखिरी में व्हाइट हाउस पर चली ईंट बोतलें, ट्रंप बंकर में छुपे. दिस इज अनदर स्टोरी हियर ऑन द फ्रंट पेज ओनली. आगे बढ़ते हैं एंड लेट्स गेट यू द लेटेस्ट एज फार एज द इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स दिस मॉर्निंग इज कंसर्न्ड. एंड द बिग स्टोरी दैट द इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स दिस मॉर्निंग इज लीडिंग विद इज द एक्शन बाय मूडीज. मूडीज has cut India's rating to lowest investment grade. That's the top story here. It's a complete analysis why this cut has come and what does it mean really for India. Everything that you need to know about this story is mentioned here. Downgrade not driven by the impact of COVID-19. This is what Moody's has said. Finance Ministry official downplays demotion, says 35 nations have been downgraded already. But there is no official response yet that has come from the government side on this. Ratings impacted. Government of India's foreign currency and local currency long-term issuer rating has been cut, and India's local currency senior unsecured rating has also been cut. Rating outlook is now negative, which is also very important because this means there is a risk of another downgrade that is now brewing. Now, what this means, India still has investment grade rating. Some investment tied to ratings may flow out of India, and there is a risk of further downgrade. So here you see a simple explanation of what this downgrade really means. A FinWin official has also told the Economic Times that we are right now focused on getting the economy back on track, which it will with the unlock 1.0 beginning today, which happened yesterday. Then manufacturing activity continues to contract in the month of May. That's another story on the front page. India's manufacturing activity contracted sharply in May, the second consecutive steep fall. The IHS Market India manufacturing PMI was at 30.8 as compared to 27.4 in April. Firms cut jobs at the quickest pace in over 15 years because of coronavirus. Then lockdown ends but not the troubles. India Inc. battles worker shortage, policy flip-flops. Most industry captains say steps needed to get migrant workers back. Remember, we've been raising this issue for a long time, that with all these migrant workers going, even though industry begins its operations, where will they get the workers from is going to be a pain point. And that's something that the industry is now raising. Then IBC tweak challenges flagged. Many questions remain unanswered. Government should consult RBI, lenders and other stakeholders before going for ordinance. This is what experts are saying. And the road towards changing the insolvency and bankruptcy code is less simple than it seemed a fortnight ago when the finance minister announced a suspension of fresh IBC proceedings in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic. That's another story. PSBs put 20,000 crore bad loans on sale. Indian economy to bounce back after lockdown curbs end. This is what Chairman Fairfax Financial Holdings has told the Economic Times. And turbulence ahead, middle seat muddle gets a new wrap. Aviation regulator says airlines should either leave middle seats vacant or passengers must wear wraparound gowns. Carriers are slamming this new order by the DGCA. And let's be more city specific and let's get you the latest as far as the national capital is concerned. Sharon, my colleague, is joining us on the broadcast for more on this. Sharon, good morning. So what's making headline this morning as far as Delhi edition of the Times of India is concerned?
Well, the guidelines by the Delhi government was in fact issued last evening, and accordingly the Delhi government has in fact decided to seal the borders with Noida, Gurgaon and Ghaziabad, all the neighbouring states. Now, we know that yesterday Gurgaon had in fact opened the borders between Delhi and Gurgaon, but Noida and Ghaziabad continues to seal their borders. Now, Delhi has also decided to seal its border. The reason behind this is because how there has been increasing number of cases in the national capital, and there could be a possibility that the government believes that a situation would arise where there would be a lack of bed, because if people are coming from the neighboring state to the national capital, it will become difficult for the health sector to deal with the situation. And that is why the Delhi government for a week is seeing that whether they will be able to seal the border with Noida, Gurgaon and other neighboring states. Also, they are in fact have planned to take suggestions from the people as to what should be their next move after 1 week, whether they should continue with the sealing. Secondly, they are also asking people that if the Delhi hospitals, the Delhi health infrastructure should only treat the people who live in Delhi and not people who are not who doesn't reside in Delhi. So this is going to be interesting to see what is going to be the decision.
Right.
The decision will be taken on Friday, Hina, after taking suggestion of the people.
All so right. Thank you very much, Sharon, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We're now moving on to the Mumbai edition of the Times of India. The big story that this edition is leading with is cyclone alert, red alert, as Mumbai braces for first ever cyclone in its history. Flash floods feared along the coast tomorrow. That's the big story. Then 85 days on, state crosses 70,000 cases. Nearly 60% cases are from the city of Mumbai. My colleague Arunil is joining us on the broadcast. Arunil, good morning. There is a red alert as Mumbai is bracing for first ever cyclone in its history. Tell us what the current situation is. What kind of arrangements are in place?
Well, a cyclone Nisarg is the name, and if you want to compare and gauge the magnitude of the cyclone, comparing it with a cyclone Amphan, which West Bengal received it less than 15 days ago, this is relatively a weaker cyclone. That's what the IMD department has said. If the cyclone Amphan was a super cyclone, this can be termed as a severe cyclone. So yes, landfall at the main focal point of this cyclone is in the Palghar district, which is around 110 kilometers from the city of Mumbai.
All right. Thank you very much, Arunil, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We're now quickly moving on to the Bengaluru edition of the Times of India. A week after restart, flights to Bengaluru log low occupancy rate. That's the big story here. Microcredit scheme will help street vendors get 10,000 rupee loans. That's another story that this edition is leading with. My colleague is going to join us from Bengaluru to get us the latest. Now, neighbors to keep tabs as focus now moves to home quarantine. That's another important step that the government has taken. Flip-flop in another shift, travelers into Karnataka will go into home isolation now as numbers too big for institutional facilities. Deepak Bopanna joining us on the broadcast. Deepak, so now there is going to be more focus on home quarantine.
Yes, that's the plan. Keep a tight watch on the people who are at home and, closely monitor their movements. They also have an app where they have to send in selfies as well. This is how they propose to actually manage the number of people who are coming in from other, states. But the concern, however, is the fact that the interstate travelers have amounted to the maximum number of positive cases in Karnataka in the recent past weeks. And now they're not even testing them if they're asymptomatic. Only symptomatic passengers are being tested. So you're literally letting loose a huge population of people who could be carrying the infection into the city, into their homes and into their neighborhoods, and potentially leading to a big outbreak.
All right. Thank you very much, Deepak, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We're now moving on to the Chennai edition of the Times of India. And the big story this morning on the front page is amid TN plan to hike doctors' pay, tally zooms past 23,000. The toll is at 184. Under revised pay structure, doctors to get 60,000 rupees. But at the same time, the number of cases in Tamil Nadu are rising sharply. And here is the count of Corona in Chennai, how cases surged in Chennai. And there you can see 1st of May in Chennai, there were 1,082 positive cases. And now on 1st of June, there are about 15,770 cases in Chennai. My colleague Shilpa joining us on the broadcast. Shilpa, good morning. Can you give us more details on this story, this pay hike, change in pay structure by Tamil Nadu for the doctors?
Well, that's what Health Secretary Bila Rajesh has told Times of India, that there will be a pay hike for the doctors because they've been working down the clock and continuously for the last 2-3 months, risking their own lives and health. So for that reason, the Tamil Nadu government has decided to increase their salary from 40,000 to 60,000. This is a quote that Health Secretary Bila Rajesh has given to Times of India. But as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, the number of coronavirus cases are still going up. Yesterday, we saw the single highest spike that the state has recorded. More than 1,000 cases were recorded. Even in Chennai, around 900 cases were reported, which is the single highest spike. So the numbers are, of course, going up, and that is a big concern for Tamil Nadu. And today, the Chief Minister, Edappadi Palanisamy, Palaniswamy will hold a meeting with senior Chennai Corporation officials to take stock of the situation, because Chennai is the worst affected districts in Tamil Nadu. So they are, of course, going to take stock of the situation and also rework on the strategy and figure out what more needs to be done to bring the situation under control.
Thank you very much, Shilpa, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. Another important story on the front page only. Partial lifting of lockdown has cut Tamil Nadu's unemployment rate to 33% in the month of May. That's another story here. Moving on now, and let's get you the latest from the Kolkata edition of the Times of India. My colleague Tamal Saha is joining us on the broadcast. Unlock day one, transport main plague city determined to return to work. That's the big story on the front page. Then unlock 1.0, day one, Kolkata means business. 40 not enough, government buses to ply on 100 routes from today. That's the big story. Response has been lukewarm, but traders in New Market are happy to open the shutters of their shops. 30% of products got damaged in 2 months. Various shops have faced this kind of a problem. Tamal Saha is with us on the broadcast. Tamal, good morning. So government buses to ply on 100 routes from now today. What does it mean?
Well, as far as private buses are concerned, even though the state government had appealed to private operators to run as many buses as possible, but then there had been a concern. The restriction is that the passengers will not be allowed to stand on board. As many as seats are available, passengers would be allowed to fill all the seats, but no one would be allowed to stand, which means private buses, which had been running with a certain amount of ticket pricing, will not be able to sustain with a reduced number of passengers on board until and unless they increase the fares. But the state government has advised not to increase any fare at this critical point. Thus, we have not really been seeing too many private buses running on the streets, which means there had been a lot of public inconvenience. People have started coming out since yesterday. They are trying to go to their offices. Some are trying to go to the factories. So the government has decided to operate more government buses in different routes in quicker intervals, so that people do not have to wait longer. People do not have to depend much on private buses, and people do not have to shell out more money to reach from one place to another. So yes, the government is trying to ensure that the COVID principle of social distancing can be maintained. At the same time, people are not made to suffer by paying any kind of premium to commute from one place to another.
All right. Thank you very much, Tamal, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We're now moving on, and let's get our viewers the latest from around the world. Here, Beyonce rallies fans to seek justice for George Floyd. That's the big story. No more seeing people of color as less than human. That's the big story that Times Global is today leading with. Divide deepens, but Trump eyes poll. Clashes continue on day six. President was moved to bunker during stir outside the White House. And look at these pictures that have captured what exactly is happening in various cities in the United States of America. Latin America, cases cross 1 million. Spain reports no new deaths. That's another big story here. Japan city seeks to ban phone use while walking. That's quite interesting. It is a scene repeated the world over. Pedestrians glued to their phones while walking, causing collisions and sometimes accidents. No more, says one Japanese city. That's a big story. Black Lives Matter. Social media companies change their profile pics. Facebook employees stage virtual walkout to protest Trump's post. That's another big story on the front page. Moving on now, and let's get you the latest from the world of sports. My colleague Karishma is joining us on the broadcast this morning. Karishma, good morning. Amit Vikas nominated for Khel Ratna by the BFI. That's the big story.
Well, yes, absolutely, Hina. The deadline to nominate players for every federation was the 3rd of June, and the Boxing Federation of India nominating Amit Fangal and Vikas Krishan for the highest sporting honour in the country, the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award. Amit Fangal had won the 2019 World Championship silver medal, while Vikas won the 2018 Commonwealth Games medal. So clearly, both of them deserving for the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award, but they will have to battle it out with other top athletes from Olympic sports and cricket, of course, like in wrestling, Vinesh Fogart, in athletics, Neeraj Chopra, in cricket, Rohit Sharma. So that is how the battle is going to be for Amit Fungal and Vikas Krishan, who have been nominated for the Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award. And the awards will obviously be held on the 29th of August, which is celebrated as the National Sports Day in India. But we will know before that whether Amit Fungal or Vikas Krishan has
All right. Thank you very much, Karishma, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. And this is something that you can find as far as the Delhi Times page is concerned. Yesterday, we got the news of Wajid Khan passing away because of coronavirus, and how all the friends and members of the Bollywood fraternity have paid their tribute. Then there's another interesting story here, how corona pandemic is changing the way people travel in cabs. All such details you can find here on the Delhi Times page of the Times of India. With this, it's a wrap. Thank you very much for staying with us here on the Newspaper Show.